It's a to-do list. It's a project manager. It's a video conferencing app. No, it's an instant messaging tool. Actually, Taskade is all of those things and so much more. So in this video, I want to show you how Taskade can replace many of your more expensive applications, but perhaps more importantly, keep you on the same page so you don't have to be switching tabs or opening up different apps. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. So let's get started here with video conferencing. And right now, I'm in the middle of a Taskade call. No, this isn't a small or minimized Zoom window or Microsoft Teams. I'm actually using Taskade's built-in video conferencing tool. So myself and my team and whoever else I invite to this call, we can actually view the same project here on the left-hand side, making sure that everyone's on the same page. And the great thing about using an integrated tool like this is you don't have to remember if you sent the correct link or not. Everyone who's invited to this project or to a broader workspace can have access to this call to make sure that everyone's on the same page. Now, it gets better than that. Down below here, we also have a chat window as well. Now, you may think that this is built into the video conferencing feature. And of course, we can be using this chat window to upload files and to communicate one another while we are on a call. But this is actually a full-fledged instant messaging system as well. So as we're working on projects, we can update one another, we can ask questions, we can mention people directly, and have a full log of that going on here as well. So no, this is not specific just to the video conferencing functionality. We can be using this ongoing. And what I love about this is that we don't have to remind people to use the correct channel or the correct hashtag. For those of you who use Slack, you may be familiar with what I'm talking about. Of course, everything that is mentioned here is going to be attached to this project so that we can stay focused on the task at hand. Well, let's dive into some of that fuller-fledged project management and task management functionality that you can see here on the left-hand side. So Taskade can be used in a variety of different ways. Here you can see I've got a variety of different checklists and tasks. Some of them are assigned to individuals. Some of them are assigned to me, for example. But Taskade can be used for note-taking, for creating an agenda. There's really a wide variety of ways in which you can use Taskade. But one of the things that I love is that you can view this information in a variety of different ways as well. So here in the top right-hand corner, you can see that we're looking at sort of the traditional or standard list view. And if you like something a little more linear, we've got our subject headings here, sort of a vertical workspace. This may be great for you, but what if you prefer something more like a Kanban view, something a little more like a board view? Well, great. Taskade has that too. So you can drag tasks over into different lists and you can manage that here as well. They also have something called an action list, which is really going to create a little more distinction between things that are actual tasks, things that are actually separated, even if they are subtasks or broken out into different branches. Now, one of my favorite views happens to be this one, and you don't get this in an awful lot of project management tools, and that is the mind map view. Now, of course, this may be dependent on the type of project or the type of task that you're working on. I really enjoy this mind map view because the way it branches out, the way I can quickly add other levels, right? The ways I can quickly add subtasks and so forth, or minimize views right here within the mind map view, something that you don't always get with other project management tools. And then that last but not least, we also have an organizational chart view. Now, this is really in many ways just the mind map view tilted on its side, right? Just rotating it a little bit. But depending on what you're working on, you may like this organizational chart view as well. Now, if you want to make sure that you have a favorite, even if other people on your team or whom you're collaborating with are changing views, you can select a default here. Here you can see I've put a star by the list view because this is the default view that I want to be using when I'm working, or at least the first view that I want to see when I'm coming in here within Taskade. Another nice few touches that I like about the project view and how you manage your projects here within Taskade is the ability to check off multiple tasks all at once? And how many times have you come back to a project and realized, oh yeah, we've already finished this up, right? Like we've done everything on this board. I guess I got to come back in here and manually check off every single thing that is in front of me. Well, what Taskade has added is an ability to check everything so that you can quickly get caught back up to speed. And that's especially helpful if you're looking at something like your own task list. So here you can see I've got a variety of different tasks that are assigned to me with specific due dates. If I, or maybe someone who is the project lead, is not checking these things off, I'm going to still see this in my task view here. So if I go back to my team workspace, let's go back to this brainstorming solutions project. If I say to myself, you know what, we've actually finished everything off here, I don't want to waste my time checking off every little tick box, I can come up here and select more, and I can select check all. Now, the nice thing is it's going to give me a prompt. Are you sure you want to do this? I think this is always a very safe measure whenever you're doing something like this in bulk. But I'm going to say, yeah, go ahead. Let's just check everything off here. And so now we're done. Now this project is wrapped up. So just a nice little touch to make it a little bit easier when you get into those positions or when you get into those circumstances and you need to check everything off. So let's go back to the workspace here. And for those who may not be familiar with how Taskade is laid out, we've got some nice subheadings here, including a calendar if you want to favorite certain projects or workspaces. And as I just showed you, your own personal tasks. So it can bring in tasks from multiple locations. But then you can break things out by different workspaces, whether it's your own workspace. I've got a personal workspace here, or a team workspace. And as you can see here on the right hand side, you know, I've got different projects within that workspace. So a nice way to organize and branch out different things that you may be working on. Now, if I want to start a new project within this workspace, I can come up here and select new. And right at the top, it's going to give me some helpful templates to get me started quickly and easily. Now, there's a few preset ones here. In fact, you can actually see a lot more if you click this option. There's a full library of Taskade templates from users in a variety of different industries. But you can also create your own. So for example here, I've created one called Team Meeting Agenda, which already has Simpletivity in the title. It already has some of my custom headings here because this is the type of things I want us to be tracking when we have our meeting together. So not only can you create your own custom templates, but you can attach them to a specific workspace. A pet peeve of mine is that as you're building out a variety of different templates and you want to go use them, but you're already within a subfolder or a particular area or a particular workspace, I don't want to see all of the templates. I only want to see the templates that are relevant for that workspace. So you can do that. Here we go back to the team workspace. If I click on templates, here you can see there is my team meeting agenda. It's waiting for me because it's specific to this particular team. So there's a quick overview of Taskade, how it can replace things like Zoom, like Slack, like Asana, or Trello, so that you can keep yourself and the rest of your team on the same page. Now, I would love to hear from you next. Which of these features are you most excited about the most? Or which of this functionality are you typically more frustrated with in terms of having to go back and forth or creating some type of linkage or integration that you would love to see here all on the same page? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Be sure to subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.